What's the role of fiber optics in the substation? Substations contain critical assets for transforming, switching, and distributing power across the grid. These assets are monitored and controlled and protected by a complex collection of devices to ensure safe and efficient operation of the grid. The products used in these applications have to be able to withstand a harsh substation environment. You've got temperature extremes, high levels of electromagnetic interference, power fluctuations, and in some cases, vibration. With the introduction of microprocessor-based devices for monitor and control and protection, there is a need for high-speed, low-latency communications in the substation to exchange large amounts of critical data. Hardwired communication links are susceptible to electrical noise and distance limitations of up to about 150 meters. Fiber optic communications are inherently immune to electromagnetic interference and provide electrical isolation between the connected devices, which drastically reduces the risk to personnel and to the individual equipment. The lightweight, ruggedness, and flexibility of fiber allows it to be easily installed in the substation. The cost to install and terminate fiber is comparable to that of copper wire. For these reasons, fiber is the preferred choice for communications within the substation. Fiber optics is ideal for asset condition monitoring. When a transformer is built, Qualitrol has a line of fiber optic transformer temperature probes that can be embedded in the transformer windings and mounted in other locations under oil in the transformer tank and as part of the transformer manufacturing process. We've got more than 150,000 temperature probes currently in use worldwide. The mean time between failure for these devices is about 100,000 hours under continuous mechanical vibration and temperature cycling. There's no drift in the temperature measurement with these devices, so there's no recalibration required. The temperature probe communicates with Qualitrol transformer temperature monitoring equipment using optical fiber as well. And the fiber optic family includes the Nomad Touch, which is a single channel handheld unit useful for diagnostics and some basic experiments. You've got the T-Guard 405 and 408, which are designed to be used in transformer control panels. And then the Omniflex 2, which is a multi-channel device usually used in the lab, can also run lab view scripts and things like that. These devices can all communicate via Modbus, some also with DNP3 and IEC 61850, so you can integrate those with substation SCADA and asset monitoring systems. The Qualitrol 509 direct winding and the Qualitrol transformer monitoring system are multi-channel recorders that include advanced calculations for integrated comparisons of simulated winding to direct winding hotspot measurements and for estimating the remaining insulation life in transformers. The Qualitrol transformer monitoring system and the T-Guard 408 also have embedded web servers. Qualitrol's Q-Link software provides longer-term logging, storage, and reporting of transformer temperatures. For more information on asset management, please read our previous blog on the asset management value proposition.